Well, in come the high flyers. Horizontal bar. In the last few Olympic cycles has produced more and more difficult routines, more and more spectacular releases. And it's more and more also the realm of the specialist. The man in orange there might be the one to get the gold. Zonderland from the Netherlands is the highest qualifier with the 15.966, with Anna Labor up first, Young Cheng Long, Eamon Gadabov, Zhu Kai looking to defend from Beijing, Hambuchen of Germany, then Epke Zonderland. If he nails it all, he will be hard to beat. Jonathan Horton and Kim Ji-hoon. You can have expectations about who might win it, Shannon, but it's always about getting through cleanly and giving a good dismount.
That's right, and this is going to be some excitement for the audience. High bar is just one of those events that is so much fun to watch, and I'm looking down the list of start values for these gentlemen, and it is enormous, anywhere from a 7-0 to a 7-5, and Jonathan Horton, who has the lowest start value of the group, a 6.8. We may see a little bit of an upgrade tonight, I think.
Representing People's Republic of China, Zhu Chenlong. Representing the Russian Federation, Emin Garibov. Representing People's Republic of China, Zhou Kai. Representing Germany, Fabian Hambuchen. Representing Netherlands, Epke Zonderland. Representing United States of America, Jonathan Horton. Representing Republic of Korea, Kim Ji-hoon. Ladies and gentlemen, the men's horizontal bar finalists.
Well, one unusual thing about this field, Channel, is that we've got all the medalists from 4 years ago in the field again. Zhu Kai, defending champion. Jonathan Horton was the silver medalist and Fabian Hambuchen the bronze. I can't think of another final where we've had that.
Well, that's exciting to watch. And these men are amazing on this event, starting off with Danielle Leva, who clinched the all-around bronze medal on this event, putting together a top performance. And he really can be a medal contender on this event. Had a horrific fall during the Tokyo World Championships last year, where he actually hit his face on the bar.
And we wish all the competitors well for this most spectacular apparatus.
Danielle is known for that wow factor. He always adds a little bit of extra flair to his routine. There's a big release. Here we go. Gold twisting to Kacha. Another big release. This is looking so smooth. Love the flare.
This is a long routine. Here comes the dismount.
He needs a stick. Double twisting, double layout. Just that step. But that was a great performance. His stepfather, Yin Alvarez, going crazy as always.
born in Cuba, moved to the United States when he was just 18 months old. And what a start we've had here on the high bar final. And Leva.
And we talk about this being only the start for this young USA team. Terrific job on these high flying release moves. In perfect position to catch. Full twist. And Danny, as he's called, he can put up a big score. Had a 15.866 during the qualification round. He'd love to see a stick, but he just had that one step, and that's about all there was to see a deduction.
Still managed to come up smiling.
Another big score.
.15833, and we're away. And Zhang Chenglong, second highest qualifier with a 15.933.
And this is really his event. Chenglong has a potential 7.7 D score on this event. We'll see if he throws it all tonight. Huge release moves, nice mixed grip catch. Four and a half over. Judges looking for these handstand positions. Completing the pirouettes as close to vertical as possible. Beautiful double-double.
And he holds on there, Zhang. You know what's impressive about Zhang is that the difficult connections he makes out of his catches. He then moves on to difficult swinging moves and grip changes off the big releases. And he just packs it in. And no wonder he qualified second best with a 15.933.
He's going to put up another huge score. Remained pretty good on that landing. It's still going to be a small error, but that was a huge routine. Good on these release moves. A lot of times China will go more towards the pirouetting versus the big release moves, and this was a good mix of both. And again, it's so hard. When you put up 7.5, 7.7 in D score, it's going to be hard for the rest of the field to catch up. Double twisting, double layout to finish. It's a very tiny shuffle with the feet.
He's happy though. He's landed safely.
That's one of those come on moments.
Yeah.
It'd be great to see one of these guys break a 16 on this event.
I think Danny Labor's under pressure here, because Zhang really put it out there.
We have seen time and again the first one or two athletes putting up the huge scores.
Oh, he's more than broken 16. He smashed it with a 16.266. That will take some topping. He was unplaced in the parallel bars final, Zhang, but I think he's got to get a medal of some sort after that performance. We're only two in, though, and six to come. Him and Gadabov.
Garabov's going to have to hit a near perfect routine to get anywhere close to a 16. It's just a huge score. Nice flight. One area he needs to work on tonight is that execution score. And right there, a mistake, came down on the wrong side of the bar. Sticking with it, we always talk about plan B. Not double-double.
And then Gadabov. Well, a pair of smiling coaches, but we could see there was something didn't go exactly to plan in the middle of the routine. And they don't reach the vertical on their handstands and come down the wrong way and to start improvising. Shannon, we've seen them do it well, though.
That's right. You know, you have to have all of those different plans in your head. And oftentimes, you've already done it in practice once or twice. You've made that mistake. So certainly something you take into consideration, but you don't want it to affect your start value in the long run. And Gerbov is coming in with a 15.566 in the qualification round. And this is a great move because you can watch the bar the entire way. I see a lot of these laid out double-doubles. And you can see how hard these guys are trying to stick that landing.
Gadabov, his score is in now, 15-3-3-3. In the third place behind Zhang and Danileva, China and the USA.
And you can see his difficulty value was hit starting from only a 7.1 today.
And Zhokai is gunning for a third gold medal here. Winning team has won the floor and looking to defend on high bar too.
And this is an amazing story because he won team high bar and floor at the 2008 Olympics as well. Could be an absolute repeat. Not quite as clean with those feet as we've seen from some of the others. Full and a half. Oh, full twisting. Release move. Nice catch. And we're just seeing some tiny leg breaks here and there.
Zhukai. A good performance. Is it in the same class as Zhang?
And he's been hit hard on his execution score. He had an execution of 8.133 during the qualification round. Got to get as close to that, really as close to the 10, but if he can get up around the 9s, that's really good.
Well, that is the event favorite right there, Epke Zonderland getting ready, but he's not next. It'll be Fabian Hambuchen, but just felt that Zhukai ran out of energy towards the end of this routine where on his last release he only just cleared the bar.
When you compare these release moves, you know, to the best in the world, they maybe just don't have the amplitude, the height, the power that some of the other athletes have. Again, watching those pirouettes, watching mainly for angles. Again, it's a little bit difficult. This is the angle you want to see from. This is the angle the judges have to see those handstands. And another little shuffle on that dismount. Haven't really seen anyone absolutely nail it tonight.
So, Zhukai. Oh, he's got 16.366. Well, he's been highly rewarded.
He has upped his difficulty value to 7.9. That's 5/10 more than he started with during the qualification round. That's huge. So even with all of those execution errors, still ahead.
So Zhukai is a chance to defend and get what would be a sixth Olympic gold medal. Enough of that. Fabian Hambuchen's up and running. This event doesn't take long. Fourth highest qualifier. A bronze medalist 4 years ago.
And this guy can post an insane D-score as well. Full twist up and over the bar. Another huge skill. Talk about high-flying release moves. Fabian has been so amazing to watch since Athens, 2004.
Hambuchen, yes! And the high bar, the bar gets set higher and higher with every performance. And Hambuchen is, he has gone crazy about his own performance. Why not? There's real excitement building here. It just gets better and better.
And Germany doing a tremendous job at these games.
We've already seen Marcel Nguyen pick up a silver medal on parallel bars in this session.
These releases are absolutely huge.
Another big one. Over the years, so I'm just watching it get bigger and stronger and braver and better.
It's been so much fun to watch him grow up from that the young man that we saw in 2004 to here. And this is a great way to finish out his Olympic career. Not that he's done yet, but certainly here in London.
So Hambuchen trying to nudge over that 16 barrier. Get alongside Zhu and Zhang. 15.633 in qualifying. Has he upped his difficulty? Zhukai leads the field with 16.366.
This doesn't happen much in girls' gymnastics. You kind of train what you're going to perform at the Olympic Games, and the guys get to high bar, and they're throwing in everything into these routines. Increase the value.
Gives the judges plenty to think about and assess. Yeah! Hambuchen is the man! 16.4! Unbelievable! Difficulty 7.5, and Hambuchen is in gold medal position. Oh, wow!
And that's where we see the execution score come into play. It was a beautiful routine. Great to see Fabian up there.
Next comes Epke Zonderland of the Netherlands from Lemmer, whose favoritism for the events been shot to pieces by the men who've gone ahead of him. He's really got to find it now. A big Dutch contingent here wishing him well.
Another huge difficulty value in this routine, 7.5.
And just watch and enjoy this man's releases.
Watch these combinations. They would have been absolutely unheard of 10 years ago. One after the next.
The gasp in the room for Zonderland, and he's far from finished, folks.
And the crowd is just going crazy.
Needs the dismount. Here it is. Got it! You won't see better.
And the crowd is on their feet.
They're standing to a man, to a woman, to a child to applaud this performance from Zonderland. He's taken them to Wonderland with that performance. Unbelievable. Under pressure. With what's gone before, to hit it like he did.
Casina. Oh my goodness. I mean, this is just one after the next after the next. I think Jaws just dropped with this routine.
You know, he's studying to be a surgeon. And, you know, you don't want him to leave gymnastics just yet, though, when he's got this to offer.
And there's that stuck landing we're looking for.
Well, it's got to be 16 and plenty. He needs 16-4 to match Hambuchen. Does he have the difficulty and the execution?
These guys have truly upped their game. We saw no one break 16 in the qualification round, and all of a sudden, one after the next after the next.
Waiting for the score for Epke Zonderland. The Dutch fans hoping that it's enough to take him to top spot. It needs to be huge. More than 16-4. Zhang sitting third at the moment, Zhu in second. Fabian Hambuchen, there's our gold medal man at the moment. It's still a couple of performances to come, and the score for this man is what we're sweating on.
Who would have thought with a 16.4 you'd be sweating whether or not you'd remain in gold medal position?
Zonderland has got it, 16.533. He had to.
I don't know what this arena would have done if he didn't.
Well, he gets a big hand from his opponents, and that's what we love seeing on the competition floor here. He's well loved. He's a brave man to try those releases. And our broadcasting colleague, Mitch Fenner across at the BBC, is one of his co-coaches, and he was confident that Epke could do it. But there's more to come.
And that is a tough act to follow. And Jonathan Horton, he put on his own show back in 2008. Kind of making up his routine during the final round, adding some extra difficulty, and ended up with a silver medal in Beijing. A veteran of the U.S. team. Starts off big. Twisting Kovacs. Oh, this is a terrific routine.
Gotta land it.
Needs a stick, double double. Oh, just step on the landing, but it was a terrific performance.
Silver medalist from Beijing, Jonathan Horton. And he, too, has given a crowd-pleasing performance.
This is just an incredible final.
I just think that the men following Zonderland, what can I do? That was unbelievable. They're certainly giving it everything.
Tap of the legs before reaching for the bar. And Jonathan has just been such a great veteran for this team. Very young U.S. team coming in. It's got to make you a little bit nervous when you look at those huge scores that have been posted before you go up.
And the man sitting in bronze medal position is 16.366. So 0.8 better than Jonathan's qualifying score. And just a Kim Ji-hoon of Korea to come.
And the crowd here getting their money's worth. This has been terrific.
There you heard it. Jonathan telling Epke that was amazing. And it, praise from an opponent is just so lovely to hear. And these men truly embracing the Olympic spirit. And Jonathan Horton, 15-4-6-6. So not amongst the medals.
I thought that was a little better than prelims.
Thought it was a little better than prelims. 6.8 start values. That's tough to get up there.
So just we've got Garibald, a big player, to come before. Garibald with head. Kim Ji Hoon is the last man. Qualified with a 15.5, so he is really going to have to find that plenty. He's the eighth qualifier.
That's right. He had a pretty low execution score, 8.2 on his execution, 7.3 in D score, so he has a good start value. Not quite up there with Zonderland. Big release. Beautiful twist in Kovacs. Very clean. Set up for this dismount. Another double twist and double. Oh, lots of steps on that dismount.
A little bit of a shame at the end there for Kim Ji Hoon. He had lots of lovely connections through that routine. But Epke Zonderland knows now that he's won it. And if 16-5-3-3 doesn't win it, there's something wrong. But what a competition. Hambuchen will surely get second. And Zhu Kai, winner 4 years ago in Beijing, will have to settle for bronze here. But all men, what I'm most relieved and pleased to be able to say, Shan, is that nobody fell.
That's right. It was a clean performance by everyone. And wow, I mean, Zonderland had the crowd on their feet. It was just so exciting to watch.
In some respects, as we look again at Kim's very good routine, it was just the dismount that had him in trouble. But
that's right. Coming in the eighth place position, he was going to have the routine of his life with absolutely no errors in order to compete with Zonderland.
Yeah. It's gonna be once again, he's congratulated, but I can't think of another performance here at the Artistic Gymnastics which has drawn the crowd to their feet. That's what happened there with Zonderland. He was so excited and so thrilled by what he did.
Well, and even the competitors, they know how difficult it is to even compete those moves individually and to link them together.
And a 15-1-3-3 for Kim, which in effect confirms our medalists, Zonderland, Hambuchen, and Zhu. In the Netherlands, Germany, and China. He hasn't stopped smiling since he came off the apparatus with a perfect dismount.
And Fabian Hambuchen, silver medal at the Olympic Games, medal at last.
Zhu Kai has had such a successful Games. Two gold and a silver. Bronze, I should say. And Hambuchen, the silver for Germany. But Zonderland, well, he came in as favourite and walks out as favourite. A crowd favourite now after that performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation for the bronze at the Levy Arena.
Well, we anticipated the enjoyment and the excitement that we might have on high bar, and oh my goodness, we got more than we could have hoped for, I think, Shannon, with the quality of the performances, the risk, the extra difficulty, all chasing the gold.
That was the most exciting final I've ever seen, Olympic Worlds, Nationals, anywhere.
Well, that's enormous praise coming from you. And again, we can't speak highly enough of the great camaraderie and sportsmanship between the competitors, which we'd love to see. And Zonderland, delighted, of course. So they'll come back shortly for the medal presentation. Very gymnastic family, that of Zonderland, the Epke's brothers, sister who competed, his parents. And he was Dutch Athlete of the Year in 2011, beating Bob de Jong in speed skating. Up they go, back soon for the medal presentation. That'll be fun. And that confirms the standings for you for the men's horizontal bar final. Epke Zonderland of the Netherlands, Fabian Hambuchen of Germany, and Zhukai of China. 1, 2, 3. High scores, all of them. Zonderland, clearly the best.